see Howard. You want to come up and give us a...
Yeah, really good news. You know, we applied for a district matching grant for an international project that our World Community Service Committee is organizing this year. And maybe we can just move forward.
Sure, sure.
So we're playing a major role in funding the building of a school in a remote village in the Swat Valley in Pakistan. The name of the village is Ar-e-Sar. And what you see here is a photograph of some of the village elders at the construction site. The ground has been leveled. The land was donated by one of the villagers. And the labor is going to be volunteer labor by the villagers primarily. So the cost of this school is about $27,000. We're playing a major role. We're donating $5,500, of which half of that comes from the district matching grant that we submitted, and it's been approved. That's the message I have to deliver. We've had the matching grant approved by the district. It's a $2,750 match. So this is going to be a great project, and we're playing such an important role in it. And the last slide, it shows.
Celebrating with sweets.
Now, I want to also tell you that half the students at this school will be female, so apparently we do not have so much diversity among the elders. But it's always been a requirement for our projects that the females are equally represented. Do you have a slide of Zabu?
I think I may have missed the mark.
Here. Well,
the
slide
earlier.
This is a... Remember, we met Zabu and her husband, Arshad, who visited us, and she's the granddaughter of the former ruler of the Swat Valley. They currently live in Princeton, New Jersey, and their life's mission is to help out people in the Swat Valley, which is a fairly impoverished area of Pakistan. So it's just great that we've got this connection.
Thank you.
Thank you.